There have been many times when Israel has been afraid. Since the reestablishment of the country, she has faced numerous wars, terror attacks, and the constant threat of annihilation. Shalom and greetings from Jerusalem. It's Joan Lippis welcoming you to Lunchtime Prayer for Israel. Well, we are going to talk today about God reassures Israel. That should make us feel awfully good. And we're going to continue this week to focus on God's promises to Israel through the words of the prophet Isaiah. Now, we know that God chose Israel to be his witness so that the whole world would know him. Why? Because seeing his goodness and faithfulness to Israel, despite their rebellion and rejection, will encourage us and inspire us to trust him and obey. Now, of course, there have been many times when Israel's been afraid. Since the reestablishment of the country, she has faced numerous wars, terror attacks, and the constant threat of annihilation. Now, God will discipline Israel for her sin and rebellion, but he will never forsake or break his covenant with the people and the land. And so we're reading today from Isaiah chapter 51, verses 12 through 16. I am he who comforts you. Who are you that you should be afraid of a man who will die, and of the son of a man who will be made like grass? And you forget the Lord your Maker, who stretched out the heavens and laid the foundation of the earth? You have feared continually every day because of the fury of the oppressor when he is prepared to destroy. And where is the fury of the oppressor? The captive exile hastens that he may be loosed, that he should not die in the pit, and that his bread should not fail. But I am the Lord your God, who divided the sea, whose waves roared. The Lord of hosts is his name. And I have put my words in your mouth. I have covered you with the shadow of my hand, that I might plant the heavens, lay the foundation of the earth, and say to Zion, you are my people. Baruch Hashem, praise the Lord. And that's why we want to pray for Israel, all Israel, to embrace God's love and trust in his faithfulness. There is no one else, except the God of Israel. Not for Israel, not for the church, and not for you. It's a good way to start the week, isn't it? And so with that, I do say shalom, lehitraot, from Jerusalem.